and the magnetics.
You can see them, they're getting sucked over to the roly-poly.
I had a really good conversation the other day with Coulter Young, the owner of miningmagnets.com. We're talking black sands, cleanup, fine gold recovery, and magnetic separation. He asked me if I had any black sands, and boom, I would say so. Look at this, 55 gallon barrel drums full, got 1.5, 1.75, these giant totes, all these buckets here. We got some larger fraction, smaller fraction, monster magnetites from the river. Look at those babies. Black sands out the wazoo. I've literally got about 5,000 pounds of this stuff. So we're gonna try out this new auger and dry magnetic device and see how it works on this material. So I'm gonna start out with this drum here. All this has already been pre-screened, but I gotta take it down to 30 mesh. So here we got our 30 mesh screen. I'm gonna fill up this whole dang bucket and run it through that magnetic separator device. When the material's dry, it screens pretty darn easily. Just gotta shake the bucket back and forth. There's my oversize. All right, full bucket. So this can run off AC or DC.
I was provided this unit for research and testing purposes.
What I got out here is a deep cycle marine battery, a little DC to AC inverter. We're plugged in where we have two voltage regulators plugged in. This one here is running the auger motor. And when you adjust the voltage, it effectively adjusts the speed, the discharge of the auger. The second regulator, I got it cranked up all the way. It's running this motor that runs the detachable roly-poly that goes into the dry magnetic separator. And here you can see the black sands dancing around, 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 down, and funneling into the black sands catch basin. This is roughly my ratio of non-magnetics, which is roughly 3-to-1 here. So the hopper is starting to run out. We're going to refill it. Now I have to say this feed auger is actually pretty slick. I can see guys using this in conjunction with cleanup sluices, possibly a Miller table, Blue Bowl, who knows, maybe even a small shaker table feed. Well, it's definitely multitasking day. We're gonna leave this here running, demagnetizing our concentrates while we're over here smelting down some assays. I'm gonna pan this material down. This is all magnetics that the machine pulled out. Now to see if there's any free milling visible gold in this material. If there's not, I'm gonna be real happy with this test. Getting late in the season. We gotta find ourselves some water. Woo! Still wanna go for a swim. It's about 4 feet deep right there. I don't wanna fall in that. Whoa. Well, I'm gonna do whatever I can to get some water without falling in. Here's our first pan, probably around 5 pounds of magnetite. Very little non-magnetics. And no gold. That's good to see. I just did 4 pans of this highly magnetic material and not a single speck of gold. I was actually thinking there might be some from our smelting tests, but nah, the roly-poly did a great job. Not a single speck of gold. Very, very, very small amount of non-magnetic material, like 0.0000001% or something like that. But no golds, that's the most important thing. For this smelt, I'm using clean crucibles. You can see the bottom is flat, whereas this one has a curved round bottom. The round bottom crucibles pour out much better. They retain less slag, collector metal, that sort of thing. And we're gonna use Chapman Flux because it expands less than my other flux recipe. The less expands, the smaller crucible I can use. Magnetite cons with Chapman Flux. This white stuff is flux thinner. So we're gonna do 2 smelts, 45 grams of collector in each. I'm gonna try to split it up evenly. Pluck these out of this here slag. One way to do it is run this stuff through a crusher and pan it real quick. So here you can see I got a piece of slag, a couple little BBs. I lightly hammer it. You can see that BB just popped right off. Pluck that one out. Yeah, there it is. Look at that. Sometimes there's some pretty decent sized ones in there, so it's definitely worth pulling them out. And we add it to the coupelle.
Second batch ready!
Crazy hot stuff. Woo.
Here's the cool slag. You can see how it broke up all glassy like. And it fell out like nothing. That's what the top looks like. Bottom, we're gonna go ahead and chisel off this slag. Here's a close-up look into the magnetic separator. Let's see if we can see that action. So the discharge from the auger is falling down into this trough. The magnetics, you can see them, they're getting sucked over to the roly-poly, which is augering them down into this black sands, magnetic black sands catch basin. Pretty cool. In this current configuration, the dry electromagnetic separator is designed to pull out 90 to 95% of all of your magnetics. It will remove all the heavier, larger magnetites, a lot of the slightly less magnetic material.
The reason for this is if you have too strong of a magnet, you will pick up everything and potentially pull out gold as well. So in the first pass, I experienced roughly 90 to 95%, probably closer to 95% magnetics removal, which is good because it won't pull any gold over to the magnetic side. And that was on the first pass. Now let's take a look at the material that has been run through the magnetic separator. I'm gonna put it all around. Very, very little. Now let's take a look at our magnetics bucket. This is what we separated out. Huge, dense, crazy pile. The feed auger is pretty slick. And if you want to remove all the magnetics, I believe Coulter creates some kind of drop funnel thing that will remove the rest of the magnetics from your material. This thing does a pretty good job. Our non-magnetic black sands assayed at 4.7 grams per ton. And surprisingly, our magnetic black sands were a bonanza. The assay results came back at 17.63 grams per ton.